What it is, what it ain't. You already know it's Talk Cat 100 going hard in the paint. The Real Field TV, which you know you're tuned into. Let's go ahead and get that out of the way. Hey, shout out to the whole 100 miles. Shout out to all the subs and all the love. You already know what time it is. To all my trolls, your favorite Floyd Mayweather Sr. and your mother is often mistaken as an Arabian sand camel. Straight up, man. I'ma always let you know how I feel, man. Now, let's go ahead on and jump into this Percy Keith and this whole Kevin Gates situation. And we really want to, you know, speak briefly on it because a lot of people have been asking for this video because a lot of people don't know what went wrong. And we're going to count down some of the things that went wrong because we don't know everything that went wrong. But what I can tell you is that, you know, BWA is also what Percy Keith used to carry on his back. And earlier on in his career, you know, people didn't know that him and Kevin Gates was also cousins along with Nook. Now, Kevin Gates took on the Percy Keith because being that Percy Keith is his, you know, smaller cousin or whatever, and Nook is, here go the thing about it. Percy Keith was always around Nook. So, unfortunately, when they had their falling out, you know, as far as Nook and Kevin Gates, he had to pick a side. And, of course, his loyalty was with Nook. Now, if you know anything about their new label, which is LNIC, which is, you know, Loyalty Incorporated, you know, correct me if I'm wrong, but, you know, that's Nook's label. And he started that after BWA. And Percy Keith is actually signed to that label. And I don't know if he has stake in that label or not, but I do know that they now getting their own money within the industry. Because what Nook said earlier and what Percy Keith was saying earlier with the BWA movement was they didn't never receive a check. Now, it was rumors around the time Percy Keith got signed with Gates that he was messing with, you know, underage, you know, females and stuff like that. But, you know, the real story went like he didn't, you know, the girl lied about her age. And what he had to do was cop out to the charges just so, you know, he could hurry up and get out of what he got jammed up in for the situation. So he that was never true. And, you know, Kevin Gates up on therapy, when he said, you know, what he said about Percy Keith, he touched on that. So y'all go look at the song Therapy and y'all will see what Kevin Gates was speaking on about the Percy Keith situation. Now, Nook, you know, he was never a rapper, but like I said, Nook was the one that was doing all of the street business, and him and Percy Keith and Mocha was actually in the streets and stuff like that. And Kevin Gates was really never around them dealing with the weight and stuff like that. You know, they used to hustle together and stuff like that, Nook would say, but, you know, he said Kevin Gates didn't know how to hustle, so he would always mess up the pack and stuff like that. Now, this is just brief things. Now, a lot of people think that Kevin Gates fell out with Percy Keith due to, you know, something that happened with his baby mother and Percy Keith. And the whole situation with that was not the fact that they did anything intimate. It was the fact that he had her chilling with the ops inside California, some ops that Kevin Gates was speaking of. And he spoke on that inside the song Dementia. And I'm pointing to these songs so y'all could get an understanding on why they was throwing shade back and forth at each other and why he now don't deal with Kevin Gates and it'll never be the same, although they all fam. It's because Kevin Gates elevated to a different frame of mind than what he used to be. You know, he's Muslim now. He's actually taking on a other path, as you can see, music-wise, too. And Percy Keith, the thing about it is, early in his career, he couldn't never get his foot on the pedal the way he was supposed to, because not because he wasn't lyrically inclined, because we know Percy Keith is one of the most lyrical dudes out of Baton Rouge, probably in Baton Rouge history. You know what I'm saying? If you really listen to this man, you know? Now, the thing is, we don't need to worry about why Nook and Gates is not really cool no more, because that's kind of already out. But as far as Percy Keith, got a few diss songs out already on Gates. One of them called Dementia and the other one called Listen Close. And like I said, Kevin Gates will reply, but he does it on his own time and he do it in such a discreet manner to where you got to catch it, because Kevin Gates will respond to one of his ops like in 3 years. You know what I'm saying? And you'll never know it. So we all got to keep our eye on that. But as far as them ever getting back together doing music, y'all can start asking me that, because Percy, Keith, and Gate, they got real family problems. So with that being said, y'all drop y'all comments and y'all let me know how y'all feel about this whole situation. And what did I miss, man? You know, salute to everybody.